Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome guys to this tutorial, and in this tutorial we're going to learn how to create a not sense of abundance sheet. So it's a student's attendance sheet. Let's learn what do we have in here. First of all, we have three sheets. In first sheet we have searching section. So according to roll number you can search for student. I have only one student, so if I type 1 according to ID or roll number. So student name appears, total days, total presence, total absence. I can add new student by clicking on submit. And now if I type 2, I have another student. Clear everything to clear everything in the here. In here, second is, as you can see, daily attendance taking. So if I reset, so all the students, new or old, will be in here. I can take their attendance and submit their attendance and go to the database section, and as you can see it has no date right now. So all you have to do is click on submit attendance. So go to the database, and as you can see it has date and present and absentees. Okay, this is it. This is what we are gonna create. There are a couple of buttons. Go to database, go to daily attendance, go to main page, and couple of that. Okay, let's learn this, how to create this in a second. Thank you guys. Let me just skip for a second. Okay guys, I'm here, and let's see how to create this sheet. Basically all you have to do is format it like this and add. We are going to first of all go to the database, create the database or the record section. So how we will create it? First ID, first name, last name, contact number, or whatever you want to put extra in here. For example, father's number, email ID, whatever you want. Total days, total presence, total absence, and about 31 days. Empty cells. Now in here all you have to do is in the ID section, as you can see, you can create this. I'll show you how to create button, but the rest of it is really easy. If you want to create, this is advanced shape, so you should know everything. Equals if function, if first name equals nothing then do nothing, else if last name equals nothing then say l dot n, and else if contact number equals nothing then c dot n. Okay, what will it do? It will tell me if I don't have anything in the first name, first section, it will do nothing. It will be empty cell. But if I type the first name but I don't give it the second name, it will say give me the last name. And if I give it last name but I don't give it contact number, it will ask me to give the contact number. Okay, sorry. Now I'll say row. So I want the row number. And from which in which cell, what cell I want the row number of, what cell I want the row number of this A10, in which I am writing this formula. So A10, and close all the parentheses. Okay, if I write first name, I'll say Muhammad Ali, it will give me an incorrect but a row number. So if it asks me to give it last name, I'll give it last name, Yasin. It all asks me to give it contact number, so I'll say something like this. So it is giving me 10. I'll go in the formula, press F2, and in here I'll say minus 9. Now I have first student, first ID and his student. So all I have to do is just drag this over number of students. For example, you have 300 or 600 students or 1000, you can just drag it until that cell. 1000 cell or whatever. So if I now type something in here, it will ask me last name. Now it will ask me for number, okay, and give me a contact, give me an ID or roll number. That's it. So let's go to total days. In the total days section, all you have to do is type equals total presence plus total absence. Now you understand why I have total days section. It means, it tells me that total days of this institute or school or madrasa, whatever. So according to this, if there were for example 3-day holidays, so instead of those holidays, we can't suggest there were three days holidays in here. We'll just say we just take their presence and absence and add them, and there will, that will be the total days instead of the holidays. It won't count holidays, this sheet. You can add holidays section in here, but depends on you. Okay, total presence, total absence, you can add total lates. Okay, in total presence section, I'll say equals count if I want the range. What I want to count, I want to count these cells in which I will have present and absentees until the end. Okay, what do you want to search for or count? I want to count, as it is total presence, I'll count P, as you can see in here, and I'll just close the cell and boom, it has everything I need. So in here, go to the B7 and click on F4, so it will just the reference will be, you can, I don't know what to call it, but it will not go down. So don't forget to do this, else it will not work. Just double click, and that's it. Now we're gonna go to total absence section. Same thing, we'll say equals count if range is the same thing in here. Okay, and after that, what am I searching for? I'm searching for the A, means absent. So in here, A and F4, and just close the cell, double click. Okay, so now our first sheet, this is the first sheet we have to create before creating any other sheets. Record section is the first one to create, and in the today's date, I have a formula called equals today, or you can say function called equals today, so it will give me date. Why am I getting sat 09/13, but you are not getting this? Because what I did is click in here and click on the custom and type DDD, so month MM / year 12. Okay, I'll click OK. So now I have this date. Basically, this is how it will work. Instead, it will look like this, as you can see. But we don't want it to be look like this, so I'll have change it or customize it to look like this.